My name is Manu Platt. I'm an assistant professor in the Wallace Coulter Department of Biomedical Engineering at Georgia Tech and Emory University, and I'm excited to share some of the photos from our trips over to South Africa and Ethiopia, where we work on HIV and cardiovascular disease. We're heading off to the University of Witwatersrand, which is where my colleague Denise Evans has a faculty appointment, and there you see me standing in front of the Health Sciences Library as a part of their medical school. And we started off there and then went straight into the lab. And here in Atlanta, again, my students do most of the lab isolation, but there I am, actually with the, we know the blood has HIV in it, and actually isolating the white blood cells from the blood that we are then going to test for our specific assay. And there you can see Dr. Gleason actually is at the very end stages of actually making sure he's got the white blood cells in that small tube from that pellet. And really this is, the purple picture shows the actual assay that we actually develop. It's very low, it's cheap to do and a very low cost, so we can do these in these low resource environments like South Africa and Ethiopia. Here you can see the white bands on this purple background. Those indicate how much of this protease activity we're picking up from the white blood cells we pulled out of these HIV blood samples. And this is our indicator to tell how bad the cardiovascular damage might be or the patient sticking with their drug regimen. So we have these samples, but actually this brick building is where all the samples originated from. Again, my colleague, Dr. Denise Evans, she works at the Helen Joseph Clinic here, and they see actually 400 HIV positive patients a day, and that's where she actually recruits the patients for our study. Now my last day, while you're in Rome, do as the Romans do, so when in Johannesburg, do as they do. And so she took me to a wonderful lion park, which is right now outside the outskirts of the city, and where you can pet white lion baby cubs, giraffes, and ostriches, and it was an amazing kind of trip, and a nice cap on the top. But because things went so well and we were able to actually perform this assay on so many samples in South Africa, we also had, through Rudy Gleason again, connections in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, working at the Black Lion Hospital. And you can see my student, Ivana Parker, in the background when I went over for a week to help out. She stayed for 2 months, I went for about 10 days. But again, really running this test, and then everything in that lab we actually brought from Atlanta and from Georgia. So it's been a great way of how we could take things that we do in the lab here and optimize them for low cost, low resource for uses in such kind of developing countries. South Africa is actually the hotbed of HIV in the world right now, with up to 15% of the population being HIV positive. So there's a lower barrier to access to these samples, particularly with the great collaboration I set up with Dr. Denise Evans. And so because of the success we've had so far with this work, we've now started a new study where we're actually taking 400 patients and we're following them from the day they were diagnosed with HIV out through 12 and 24 months to look at how this activity has changed for them so we can do this in a patient-matched way. And because of this work, we're actually going back soon, and I'm actually taking 6 of my graduate students and postdocs with me to a major conference over in South Africa. But of course, before we get to the conference, a few of us are going to stop back by Witwatersrand and run a few more samples that have been collected to add to this data that we've been collecting. So it becomes this international partnership between Georgia Tech, Atlanta, and also Johannesburg and the University of Wits to really come to some novel ways to solve these problems.